So this is DNA. I'm sure you all know the structure. It's a double helix. And these are the four letters here. I hope you can see the colors. And even these four letters are not actually standing alone. Each of them is occupied in a base pair. So the four letters are two base pairs. This is all our life. So if you want for your chemist or whatever, I hope that you all, the chemists all know it, but this is the actual structure. So here, for instance, this triplet will code for a specific protein, a specific amino acid, but the information is not available. It is masked by the structure, by the double helix. So what really happens in the cell? DNA is sitting here. These are the letters. Letters are also called bases or higher language nucleotides. First of all, in order to make them available, they are being transcribed to a similar molecule called RNA. In this particular case, it's messenger RNA, which has the same base pairing character, but it can also stay as a single helix. And here the letters are available, can be read. So this process from here to here is called transcription, and it gave, understanding it, won the Nobel Prize in 2006 by Roger Kornberg. So after there is transcription, there is translation from here to the protein. This is what we talk about now, and this is the growing protein here, and it's done by a cellular machinery called ribosome. So I wanted to understand how this complex or assembly or particle, whatever you want to call it, how does it work? I didn't have to discover it. It was discovered before me. I also didn't have even to find out what are the components. At least for a few bacteria, it was known before me, but not how it works. The idea was that it's not possible to find it out. So, but this is what I wanted to understand. We like to describe the ribosome as a factory. Factory that makes proteins according to instructions. So here are the instructions coming into the factory. And each triplet that sits here is coding for an amino acid. So let's say that this triplet is here, and this is the amino acid that is being coded by it. So it will come in and be bound to the newly born protein that comes out here. So far unfolded, but it will fold. So this is what will happen inside. Sorry, I cannot draw inside, so I drew it outside, but this happens inside the factory. So this will now coming here, the protein will be longer by one amino acid. The track, which is also a molecule, RNA molecule, transfer RNA, or tRNA, it will go out and look for another job. That's what we think the ribosome is doing. Meanwhile, the messenger will progress by one triplet, and the whole elongation cycle, which I just talked about, needs not much energy, but needs energy for those that are interested, 2 GTP molecules. That's the way we look at the ribosome. So you see now the tracks are empty, and the messenger can go out, and everybody can look for more duties. I just want to show you the track, how the track looks. It's a tRNA, L-shaped molecule, with here an anticodon that can make a base pairs with the codon, and here the cognate amino acid. So let's see how clever is the ribosome. Here is a messenger RNA that brings the message, a long, long line. I say that each triplet is coding for amino acid, but where are the triplets? If I was a ribosome, I would get completely lost. This can be a triplet. this can be a triplet, this can be a triplet, and each of these possibilities will dictate different triplets all through the chain. So what is right? The ribosome knows. It knows to identify the triplets. Second step, once the triplets are already known, and here they are shown, each triplet by this blue, purple rectangular. So this is a triplet now. These are the correct. Where to start? Which is the first one? So there are signs and symbols on the messenger, but the ribosome has to find them. And it finds. And when it finds, once it associates correctly, the first tRNA can come and make, here is the tRNA, as you saw it earlier, make codon-antacodon interaction here. This is the codon, the triplet is called codon. This is the anticodon, and you see it makes the same, will make the same type of pairs. And the cognate amino acid is here. This process is performed by the small ribosomal subunits. So all ribosomes, bacteria, human, elephants, whatever you say, all ribosomes have two subunits. One subunit is here. And the small one is the one that associates the message, determines the triplets, finds out if the first interaction is correct, actually finds out all interactions. It's like the brain of the ribosome. All the thinking is there. And we think that it makes, I'll talk about mistakes in a minute, we think that it may make mistakes in the step of decoding, but it's so fast, it has a proofreading machinery and it corrects it so fast that not always we can catch it. So here is the small subunit. Now the peptide bond, it's the bond that connects the amino acid, is made by the large subunit. It has to make the first peptide bond, the second peptide bond, the third, and so on. It's a polymerase, and also to protect the newly born protein. So this is the first position in the small one. And always the one that is being decoded will be in the first position. It's the next position to be occupied. And this is after there is a bond, the first tRNA can go out. So this is a site for after. And the names are A, P, and E, and it's not so important now. So instead of talking, if I can get real dark, I'll show you a movie.